Well, hey friends, Jennifer Allwood here. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to increase your engagement on Instagram because, like, it's hunky-dory that you have an Instagram account and that you've got a couple followers, but if you're not getting engagement, then nobody is continuing to see your content. And so engagement is important. It's important not to just post something and get crickets. And so I had somebody DM me a while back and she was asking me, like, Jen, are there any great books on social media? She knows I have, you know, 360,000 followers on Facebook and 90,000 on Instagram. And I'm like, no, honey, there aren't. And the reason that there aren't is because it takes so long to get a book into print. Just ask me how I know how. But I told her by the time a book would get to print, like, it would be old news already because the game is always changing. But for right now, today, engagement is still really, really key. And so so you've got to have good engagement on your Instagram. So if you're new here, please subscribe to my channel. I'll be coming out with a couple more of these videos on this topic soon. I don't want you to miss it. Hopefully on the next time I do a video, my voice will sound a little more normal. It's sounding a little bit like a 12-year-old, you know, middle school boy, but it's okay. It's okay. I still got some stuff to teach you here, okay? So watch this video, and then I want to make sure you know we have a free resource at the end of the video. So watch all the way to the very end. I've got a freebie for you there. So three ways that you can increase engagement on your Instagram right away and why it's so important. And the reason it's so important is, like I said, you want people engaging because otherwise you're going to post something and nobody's going to see it because of the algorithm. You know, doesn't algorithm like sound like a dirty word? That's how we should say it. Because the algorithm does not play nice all the time. And the algorithm basically says this: if Jen posts a picture on her Instagram account and there's only, you know, one or two people that comment, well, the next time Jen posts something, like, we're not showing it to as many people. And in fact, that one that she only got one or two comments on, the algorithm basically says, yeah, nobody's really loved this. So we're gonna kind of do this on that post as well. Does that make sense? Like, that's how the algorithm works. It basically is like, this post, lots of people are commenting on. Well, let's show it to even more people. Let's show it to even more people. And then on the next post, let's show that to more people because she got a lot of reach the last time. Does that make sense? Hope that that makes sense. I feel like I just got a little shouty about the algorithm. Sorry about that. Okay, so how are you going to increase your engagement? Number one, I want for you to be posting content that's really shareable, that's like Me Too type of content. Okay, so what I mean by that is this: when people are on your Instagram, dun, 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 and they're looking at Jen Allwood's Instagram account, and they're reading my last post, and they're reading my last post about, you know, how everything's smoke and mirrors, and they're like, oh my gosh, yes, yes, like, that's exactly what I think, me too, yes. That's when they will hit the share button down below. Now, if you don't even know what the share button is down below, it looks like a little paper airplane, and it's below every single post you see on your feed, in the Instagrams. And so you want people to hit that share button and share it to their stories. You want them to do that, or send it to their friend, Carrie Robina, their friend, Jamie Nato, their friend, Fit Rocker Chick, their friend, Jenna Kenyon. Like, those are the top people that come up on my shares. But you want them to be sharing it. Plus, and they'll share it when they feel that Me Too reaction to something that you post. Or you want them to read it and it's like, it's something deep, it's something thought, it's something that hits them in all of the feels. And you want them to, like, tag their friends. That's right, the dog's saying yes, tag your friend. Lola, it's a friendly. I'm sorry. Dog life is hard. Dogs in general are hard. And Lola is, she's... She barks at her shadow. So we're just going to ignore Lola. But you want for people to read your post. And if it doesn't make them think of themselves, that you want them to think of a friend of theirs immediately that they can tag, like, you know, the @ Carrie Robina, like, oh my gosh, thought of you. @ Jenna Kenyon, oh my gosh, thought of you. Does that make sense? So you want them to either go, yes, me too, and share it and comment on it. Or you want them to go, not me, but my BFF. Not me, but my sister. Not me, but my neighbor. Not me, but this girl in my industry. And tag and share it with them. That is content that is shareable. And that's going to take you probably being vulnerable. It's going to take you probably being different than what everybody else in your industry is. Might require you do some polarizing content. I had a podcast episode on that recently. But that's how you really, like, flesh out the people that are not your people and magnetize the people that are your people. By doing really great shareable content. That's number one. Number two, you need to do IGTVs. Okay, so listen, for those of you who are like, I don't know about IGTV, let me just tell you this. It doesn't matter if you don't know. Instagram's basically saying, we want you doing IGTV, which means it doesn't really matter how you and I feel about IGTV. The fact is, if we want stuff to be showing up in the feed of Instagram, we've got to be doing IGTV. If we want a bigger reach on Instagram, we've got to be doing IGTV. So Instagram has made it a lot easier now. It used to be that you had a whole separate app for IGTV. And I was like, what the what? I'm not doing another thing, Instagram. Like, you're not the boss of me. Fear is not the boss of me, but Instagram's not the boss of me either. But then Instagram like put it into the regular, Instagram app. So now here's what you need to do if you're going to do an IGTV. You're going to get on your iPhone. You're going to click on your camera. You're going to put your camera on a tripod or rubber band it to a wine bottle or something. Well, don't do this, but rubber band it to something if you don't have a tripod. I literally have something right here that's on my Amazon store. It's called a gooseneck. And this clicks to the top of my cabinets. This holds my phone. And so I can always do a video hands-free because you need to be hands-free because otherwise things just get awkward. Your IGTV has got to be less than 10 minutes. So you're going to record it in your camera, just hitting the video button. And you're going to record for less than 10 minutes. And you're going to make sure that the lighting is good, which means you're sitting facing a window somewhere in your house. Or you can use a diva ring light. I've got this in my Amazon store, I believe also. If you don't know how to find my Amazon store, you can go to the Googles and type in Jennifer Allwood Amazon store and look under my business products. That's there. So either good artificial light or you need to be like looking straight at a window with the phone in between you and the window. Does that make sense? Because lighting is everything. People won't stop for, they will stop for great lighting. And they will stop for something catching their attention on the feed. So I suggest you wear something that's an attention grabber. If you don't have big blonde hair, that's okay. Get yourself a bright colored shirt. Make yourself do something that sticks out in the feed of Instagram. Does that make sense? So IGTVs, make sure that they're less than 10 minutes and do them. That's the bottom line. And do them. And now you can do this really cool thing, which is probably way too much in-depth conversation, but now you can do this really cool thing where you're putting your IGTVs into series, which is also really cool. So that's number two. Number three, I want you to almost think of the content you're putting on Instagram back to what we used to do in blogging 10 years ago. So I started blogging like 12 years ago. And we used to almost use it as a diary. And I'm not saying to use your Instagram as a diary, but I am saying that a lot of long posts do really well. They really do. And a lot of times people will, if they have too many words, they'll even go down and put like continuation in the first comment. And I don't know if you have that much to say, but what's always frustrating to me about Instagram is the layout though, when I'm typing up my content. Because if you have too many spaces after a period, then it squishes everything together. And I really like visually, my brain likes to read a line, see a blank line, read a line, see a blank line. And it doesn't always lay out like that on Instagram. So I'm going to tell you a trick. I always go just to the notes in my phone and I type up my my long posts to go on the Instagram feed. And then I come back to Instagram, put the photos in and copy it into there from my notes. Because otherwise it gets janky. It's not very easy actually to write a really long blog post in Instagram. So go do it over in your notes of your phone and just copy and paste it. But make sure that there's something in it for the people who are watching. See, the problem is a lot of people when they're doing a long post on Instagram, it's all about them. It's all about them. And we live in a world where everybody wants it all about me, all about me, all about me, all about me. Did you guys ever see that Joyce Meyer segment? It's hilarious. So if everybody's like, what about me? What about me? What about me? Then you need to make sure that when they're reading your Instagram post that's long, you're somehow relating it back to them, relating it back to how it can improve their life, their business, their circumstance, their thought process, their day. Because if you can relate it back to them, then that goes back to point number one, which was make it shareable. Make it shareable. All right. I hope that was helpful. I'm going to recap those three things. Number one, shareable content. Ask people even to share it. Ask them to tag a friend. Make it shareable. Number two, start doing IGTVs. No longer than 10 minutes, but start doing them. You do them on your phone, in your camera, and you upload them to the Instagrams. And number three, do it blog post style, but I want to make sure that it's something for the people who are actually reading it, that that there's something in it for them. And I do it over in the notes section of my phone and just copy and paste it over. So hope that this was helpful. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do while you're here. I'm going to have another video really soon. It's going to be all about Instagram story hacks. And let me just say this, Instagram stories are my jam. Like, don't mess with me and my Instagram stories. I love them. Like, I double heart them. I triple heart them. So come back for that. And go to the link that's in the description of this video. We have a cute little quiz for you. And it's basically helping you to determine your social media IQ. Everybody loves a good quiz. So go take that. It's going to connect you to some more trainings about social media. I'm glad you're here. I will see you again with another video soon. Be blessed.